Stop comparing yourself to other people.
Aquí estoy con un celebrity stylist, okay? Celebrity stylist, James Collins, keep going. He was telling me some stories. Who did you work with? Tell me, keep going. Just keep the story rolling. You can do this.
I was a color educator for Regis for 3 years. Mm-hmm. And then I decided on I want to get back behind the chair. So I started working at Identity Salon this fall. One of the top salons in Cincinnati. And they bring stars in. I did Ken Griffey Jr. hair, his wife, TV people, you know. It's a high-end salon. It had a spa in it. So I did that for maybe about 5 years. And then in the meantime, this young lady, I was doing her hair, and she asked me, she said, how can you get closer to my scalp whenever you color my hair? I say, I don't know. Like that.
That's your talent.
And then I started working down in my basement, and I'm just coming up with something. And actually, I just doing things. I'm working on a mannequin with it. And I said, came up with this way, that way, on this side. I was just trying stuff. And I was just having fun. And next thing you know, I made the little tool by hand, totally. And I still got the original one. Yeah, man, I made it by hand. It was, it was fun. And then I started taking it to work, and people were asking me, hey, where you get this thing from? I said, it's mine, you know.
Oh, wow.
You know, yeah, I was like, you know, like a little kid in the candy store. It's mine, you know.
It's mine. Now it's mine.
Yeah, and so people were using it, you know. They were using it, asked me, you know, hey, can you make me one? I'm like, the price is right. You know, I used to be joking.
Yeah.
They like, you something else. So I was just joking around. And next thing you know, this young lady I worked with named Bridget, she was serious. She like, make me one, I'm serious. I'm like, okay. So I stayed, I did. I made them maybe about 4 or 5 of them. And I started thinking, wow, I'm gonna have something, you know? So I did what they call a patent search on these things. No one had anything like it. And so I said, wow. So I applied for a patent. And I couldn't believe this because my sister was a hairstylist too now. And I used to pick at her all the time. I'm like, look what I'm doing. And she was older. Oh man, it was crazy. And she's like, I'm so proud of you, you know. I'm like, well, you know. And then after I patented this thing, I had to find a manufacturer to produce it for me. I had to. I'm on a mission now. You know, I'm like, I want to be doing this, you know. It was back in the day, and I was like, wow, I can't believe this. Just starting off like that.
Yeah, wow.
And then I went to Indiana, because up there is like tri-state, Indiana, Ohio, and Kentucky.
Yeah, close by.
Yeah, they close by. So I went over to Indiana, a little plastic company. I went up in there, and I said, hey, how much you charge to make this for? They told me the price. I said, God.
You said,
that's why they go to China.
Oh.
I said, nah, that's okay. My dream will kill me.
Your dream.
You're killing my dream right
you
now.
You said, my dream has
shoot,
to
man, shut. They were killing my dream. Well, I said, man, this is what's going on. So I said, you know what, I don't know about this, you know, I'm just saying. So, make a long story short, about a week or so ago, go again, I go over in Ohio. And I tell this story all the time, people at these schools, and they like how I got started. I tell them the story, I said, I went to Ohio, went to a company over there, and I said, Lord have mercy, man, it costs a lot to get this.
Yes.
I said, I'm like, God, I can't believe this is happening. You know, I'm thinking a couple $1,000s, more than a couple.
Oh, absolutely.
I said, okay. So after they told me their price, I'm like, I think I'm pretty good.
You're going to do yourself at your basement every night just working for 24/7.
You're going to have to figure out something. So
that's funny.
My last results, I went over here in Kentucky. I went in and I seen this lady. I said, what you doing in here? She's like, what you doing in here? Like that. She was my client. And I couldn't believe it. I like, oh man, I'm gonna show you how God worked. It was my last results. So I said, can y'all make this manufacturing produce this? She said, hold tight. I'll be back. So she went and got two engineers. They said, come on back, Mr. Collins. They called me Mr. Collins. I'm like, damn, they called me Collins.
I like that. I was like, they talking to me.
They said, okay. So we go back and we sit down at the table and say, everything is starting from paper. He didn't give me no price. I'm like, oh, okay. They said, we can do it. Give us 6 weeks and we'll get back with you. I said, okay. All right. They gave me a little time to get my little papers together.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Because you thought, I know you thought,
I'm a baller now.
You missed a college.
And I never forget. They said, they called me up. So we ready. I said, for real. 6 weeks went by. I said, man, I can't believe this is happening. I went over there. And went in there. They sat down. They showed it to me from the paper to there. I'm like, wow. You know, like that. And then we sat down.
You were in disbelief.
Oh, yeah. I couldn't believe this. No, I couldn't believe none of this. And so what happened was that they showed it to me and they were gonna get started. They said 65. I said,
did that man say 65?
You said 65. Did that man say 65? What are you talking about? 65, that's what I said. Mm-hmm. Said 65,000. My eye went like this.
Let me drink some coffee. 65,000.
I said, that boy can't be talking to me. But it was cheaper than 100 over here. I said, damn, 65. I said, I'll be back. Went and got him a cashier check for $35.
Okay.
So you better cash it today, because Mark.
There today, that's
I'm telling you. Yeah. I'm telling you. Yeah.
And that's how the pilot started.
That's how it started. So, wow. Man, they told me to give me about 2 months before they get them done. Mm-hmm. And then I was at work, I'll never forget, it was a Friday. It's a Mr. Collins, we ready. I said, for real? He said, yeah.
You must have felt like,
I did. I'm like, wow, I can't believe this is happening. Wow. I just couldn't believe everything was just like a dream coming true. I got something no one else have, and I did it myself. So when I got there, they were popping them out. Pop, 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 pop. I said, my babies are born.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Your babies are born. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah,
you,
man.
And you had no idea how to promote it.
I didn't. Nope. This is what happened. Yeah. So after I picked up a few of them, I left some on the pallet, whatever, they boxed them up. And I came home to Georgia at that time, and I was showing my mom, my sister, I was showing them, hey, look, I got my own product, this is my thing. And they were like, oh, yeah, because that's what family is. Oh, yeah, boy, whatever, like that. I was like,
look. I can get closer to the side now. I can color better.
Yeah. Wow. So I came back. I tried to sell some of them, but couldn't sell them. No marketing, no nothing. So what I did was I went back to college and got my business degree and learned about marketing. That's what happened. So if anyone that got anything about business, go to school. Get some education. That's the best I can tell them to help yourself.
But also work.
Work.
You can't live off dreams.
No, you can't.
Live off, I'm getting an education. I'm going to be rich.
No, it don't work like that.
It does not work.
No, it don't work like that.
Because you could have the best education, but if you don't reach out, if you don't approach people, if you don't show, if you don't show what you have.
Right. I agree. You don't have anything.
Yeah. And as stylists, we need to also help each other out.
Exactly.
And teach. Share our knowledge as well.
That's the best. That's what I always say is, it's the best thing helping another person.
Yes.
Because some knowledge that you don't know that they can give you inside sight on it, I've been doing this for 24 years.
A colorist, right?
Colorist, yeah. It's enjoyable. I love it.
Me too.
I still had a passion.
Me too.
I love seeing artwork done. It's the beauty of it.
You're right, it is artwork.
Coloring
is artwork.
It's artwork. It's the beauty of it, the outcome of it, the vision that you have. That's what I love about it. And I love doing it.
And anything to make our job easier, because you know when you do, you take the foils and you lift with your hand, mm-hmm. you have to kind of like
hold it and maneuver. Put it on there. That's it.
On the palette, it was amazing working with it. I didn't know how to act.
It's you know, once, and I tell people this, once you get used to them things,
yeah.
This year is one of the best years that I've had in my industry, because last year when I did the hair show, mm-hmm. I got more exposure. I did the international hair show.
Okay.
And I got more exposure. And this year here, when I just been networking with a lot of people, mm-hmm. Actually, we're in the process of getting them in four schools now. Four schools. Mm-hmm. Celebrity in the UK getting ready to sign on.
And you only have two products, the Easy Palette and the
case for now. Yeah.
That's for all now. You need.
Yeah, I'm working on some more stuff, but it just takes time.
Yeah.
You know, so because financially I'm doing everything myself.
Wow.
My daughter like, Dad, go get a loan, this nothing, because see, you know what I believe in? I don't have to pay anybody back.
Wow. That's amazing.
That's the way I look at it. Because when things start really rolling, you don't have to like, hey, I gotta do this. No, mm-hmm. I'm doing this. And that's what I feel comfortable about.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying?
You can sleep at night.
I can sleep at night. Mm-hmm. Exactly. And I feel like I want to be one of them kind of people that, not a boss, but more or less kind of like, I'm a partner.
And that's why it will succeed.
That's the way I look at it. Mm-hmm. Because I don't work with a lot of people. Mm-hmm. To me, a managing skill is horrible.
That's I can giggle about that.
I'm just saying.
That is.
I don't work with some.
I have to agree on that.
You know, that's just the way it is, though. To me, in this industry here, you have to partner up with people, not try to dictate them or try to micromanage them.
Exactly. No, there's no such thing as micromanagement in this industry.
That's what I'm saying.
Because we're artists.
We are.
And our creative minds, I mean, the sky is the limit.
It is.
So,
that's what I love it.
You know, when your box says Balayage highlighting, and here I am using it as a raider. I put my. I made this out here, and I see some videos on it. I just put, you know what? Let me just put the little brand there. Because I was doing several things. Mm-hmm. So let me just put the little cream here and there. And then I thought about MUAs. I said, wait a minute, makeup artist, because I like the material. It's so smooth. You can put on there the foundation.
Yeah.
You can create your eyeshadows, you know, and you can do your mixing and matching.
Yeah.
And so I said, wait, MUAs can use it too. I'm just going to put my makeup on here and mix it. And then my daughter is a painter.
There you go.
once upon a time.
See?
So I said, hey, Janelle, can you use this palette? She was, oh, yes, because she uses a mirror.
See?
So being so smooth, like the material of a mirror, that helps a painter.
See what I'm saying? With different options.
Yeah, different options. So it's not just for hair. And that's when I say creative mind.
See? It's different options.
You can't just get stuck on one thing. And that's why we can't be micromanaged.
Thank you.
That's my point. Don't cry.
It's your neck. I know, man. I'm just saying.
Yeah, so.
I'm just saying.
Yo, this is celebrity stylist James Collins. He's just humble. But he's the creator of Easy Light. So y'all know what to do. Reach out to me, okay? Talk to you.